हेलो हेलो, हाय सर।
हेलो,
हाय हाय, वेरी
हाय पुनित, गुड इवनिंग.
गुड इवनिंग सर, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम डूइंग गुड पुनित, ग्लैड टू सी यू.
फैंटास्टिक। यस, सेम हियर। फैंटास्टिक। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर डूइंग दिस। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कमिंग लाइव विद अस टुडे एंड टेकिंग आउट योर प्रेशियस टाइम। एंड
इट्स माय प्लेजर टॉकिंग टू यू टुडे एंड लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू अ ग्रेट डिस्कशन.
So again, you know, just a very warm welcome once again to you. Thank you so much. And Elvis, you know, how we want to start is we really want to know your journey. You know, how did this begin? You know, your entire when you did your education, and then finally, how did you get into photography, and how did this happen to you? So we'd really like to know this about you.
So I would probably say to for me to understand that photography is my passion itself, it took a lot of time because I am. From a village called Nazareth, which is in southern part of Tamil Nadu, and it is so at that point of time, I don't even know that there is something called as a wildlife photography as a profession. Okay,
right.
So that time it is always like, say, my mother is a doctor, so I should have become a doctor, but I became an engineer. So but my first interaction to photography, not even wildlife photography, was almost like 20 years before, where I have. That time it was the roll. There was no digital photography, so you can take 36 shots, come back, and then you need to process, not the post processing, but you need to
yes.
process those film rolls. I've actually yeah. learned that, how to work in a dark room, how to do that, and that is the first touch with photography. But at that point of time, I was doing my engineering, and I definitely have a great passion towards wildlife, but at that point of time as well, I don't have absolutely no clue. So by the time, obviously, so I would say, I completed my engineering. I specialize in supply chain. So I even started my job there. It was a very good career. It was going all well. But I then started photography as a passion, and then passed around 4 years. I am doing wildlife photography.
So Elvis, how did wildlife come into picture? You said you talked about, you know, initial days of you getting into the photography thing, and you know, the initial
right.
days of photography, but then how did wildlife happen to you?
Okay, so let me put this way, that's what, so there is something called, see, the genre of photography, it is very difficult to guide someone. I can't tell you, hey Puneet, get into wildlife, it is very good. It's not like that. So first, the photography is just the technical side of it. Okay, so when I started also, I shoot, even I remember on my college days, I take almost 5 to 6 rolls of the camera roll. So 6 times, 36, around 240 shots you can take. I used to complete them. So I need to take a lot of people. I need to take some nature shots. And then when I started doing this, I realized I liked when I'm shooting wildlife more. That is where you understand what is that inner passion lies in, right? That is the transformation. And some people do initially wildlife, and then they will try to do, okay, now wildlife is there, let me do a serious birding, let me do macro, let me do people photography, let me do street photography. People diversify like this also. You can do that. In my case, it actually happened the other way around, which I started shooting everything, then I realized, okay, this is really good, and I've started focusing more and more on wildlife. Actually, that specialization is the important thing. That specialization actually helped me when I backed these additional roles from the different conservation organizations. So I would suggest, don't ask anyone, what is your passion?
Yeah.
You need to find it. I think that is the key takeaway. Basically, you should not find out someone is doing. Basically, if you see my Instagram account, initially there was a lot of birds. Now it is narrowed down to only tigers. Right? There is nothing wrong in it. Till the time you are happy with it, it is absolutely fine to do that. But this alone, don't take any suggestions from others. You try to shoot whatever possible. Then automatically or gradually, you will understand what is your passion or where it lies and go towards it.
Right. Totally agree to the point. Any thoughts you want to give to the people, not from just photography standpoint, but anybody who wants to do something in their passion, how can they begin? What should they do? Because there are a lot of times I've seen people, they just don't do it, and they have so much talent and they know they can do it, but
right.
something stops them. And you are the perfect example. So any thoughts which you want to give them, which might just motivate them,
see,
if they see this?
Right. So people who are passionate, first of all, we are talking only about people who are passionate. The only thing which may stop them. For example, someone is really passionate about photography, right? Obviously, they will think about what will I do for my day-to-day expenses, how I am going to fund for my additional hobby or a passion. This is what I'm talking about. We are not talking about someone who is right from starting on their passion. They are the real lucky, blessed people. So there are someone to guide. So I am not talking about them. I am talking about someone who's doing something, but they are passionate about something, they need to start it. So for them, when you are in that kind of a 9-to-5 job, because you are in a job, you are in a profession, please don't get into a habit of taking loans. Because loans and EMIs, things put a lot of pressure on you. And moment you are habituated to it, it's always in your monthly, you need to work for something to fund for it. The first time, even when I was becoming an entrepreneur, the first thing what I've taken, keep aside other things. I'm not even talking about passion, how good you are. I'm not talking about that. The first thing, monetarily, you should be a free man. So from that day one, when I get my house, when I get my car, when I get my new photography equipment, nothing is on credit. Because that is a negative impact on you, because you will hesitate. You will hesitate to take the next step. Can I do this? So this is the first key thing in terms of doing this. Number one. Second thing, now that you are free from any of the money related negative impact, talk to a lot of people. You need to get information. Information is the key. You should not just talk to one person and then decide, hey, this is it. Because they may told whatever they know in a good intention, but you need to reach out to a lot of people to find out what it is actually, and then come up with the kind of a game plan. Like, okay, this is where I am. This is where I need to go. It is possible. What are the steps I need to do? And don't take for, this is the third one, don't take it for granted that I will learn from my failures. Because sometimes, if I'm, assume after 10 years, I become a very successful wildlife photographer, and I'm going to come and tell you, see, I failed a lot of times, but I've learned a lot. It is very easy for me to tell that. But at each failure, you are going to lose your time, you are going to lose your money. So I'm not telling that you should not fail. But don't take it for granted that if I can fail and I'm going to learn. Don't do that. Try to do it right the first time. That is where I ask you to talk to a lot of people. Make a stepwise plan, and then you go towards your the goal. And never stop and look back. Whoever, whatever it is, because I know a lot of people now, you may get specifically photography as a profession, or many professions are not very visible. Okay, now everyone knows cricket at home. I'm talking about specifically parents, because they want their kids to be successful. What they see, they think that this is successful. Cricket, okay, great, this is successful. But the same kind of recognition may not be there for hockey or a football. Now things are coming up. Suddenly, badminton, shuttle became very famous. Why? Because they have seen PV Sindhu on TV. Right? So there is a perception. Now this is your responsibility to be clear. First, you have to be clear. Then show to the people who really you want to take them along with you. That is your parents. Tell them, hey, this is how this is going to be, right? And this is how I can be successful. If you can't convince with that information your parents, that means you are still not clear. If you can't convince your parents with that information of step one, that means you are not clear. Please do these three things, not just wildlife photography. Any profession, you can have a way to get it done.
Wow. Elvis, trust me, this has been the most practical advice I've heard and listened. So thank you. Thank you so much. I'm sure it's going to help me too. And we're going to, of course, you know, post this video, post this session, and a lot of people, I'm sure, will get benefit out of this. So I think another call for the audience. Sorry, you're saying something. Yeah, please.
Yeah, so it's a pleasure. I think, yes, this information, what you guys are doing on your this startup is fantastic, because you are taking unconventional roles. You are not putting doctors and engineers who are already very famous in India, right? So now you are showing there are multiple different professions. We need to do this more and more. Probably we need to do a session just on wildlife as a profession, because you know what is the biggest problem? When, now assume, I don't know about wildlife as a profession. I am doing like a hobby. When I get more and more followers, when people reach me, because I get hundreds of messages in Instagram and Facebook, I will, without my knowledge, I will start misleading people. I will start telling people with a good intention, hey, don't do this. You can't make money out of this. And please take this as a last summarized view from my side. To become a doctor, it takes 6 years. To become an engineer, it takes 4 years. You can't become a wildlife photographer in a day. You can't expect it. You need to put that much years of effort to become a wildlife photographer. It is, that is one thing you should be very clear about, right? You can't, now if I'm telling my mother is a doctor, now I want to become a doctor. Tomorrow I want to become a doctor. No, I need to invest 6 years of my time and then probably another 2 years working in a hospital. Similar kind of expectation. You keep it for wildlife because people in a hurry, wildlife photography, I want to immediately become. Please don't do that. Invest the same amount of time and reach out to a lot of people and understand what is this. Definitely, if you can invest that much of time, you will be very, very successful in this profession.